Now here we are to have a wee look at a wee amp, and this is Yamaha's little home practice amp, which is only 5 watts, and it's a tiny little thing. As you can see, it all lights up, and there's the size of my hand compared to it. And I don't know if you can see the keyboard behind it. It's a 1.5 octave amp. It's a new standard in amplification. Now I'm going to turn it down on its face so that you can actually see what I'm doing with the dials. And the guitar I'm using to demonstrate it is an Epiphone 339. With flat wound strings on it, so it's quite a mellow sounding instrument in its own right. So we'll start with the clean sounds and we'll work our way up to the nasty noise section. At the top we have clean, crunch, lead, Brit high and modern. Okay, so clean, and there's quite a volume variation on these things, so if you think it's quite quiet at first, Just bear with it. It will get a lot louder as we go on. And that's me on both pickups. Now we go to the next one and things get a lot brighter. As you can hear, it's still actually clean. And there's a good bit of reverb on it as well. Now, while we're here, let's have a listen to the different effects. We'll give it maximum reverb. So good for your surf rock. Now, as we go down, we have, that was hall, this is now spring reverb. Slightly different. Delay reverb. And you can actually hear a repeat there. Okay. And a few repeats. And then down there we have the kind of basic one. If you deaden the chord. That sort of effect. I'll put it back up to a modest amount of reverb. And here we have our different effects. Nice bit of chorus, flanger. Phaser. And lastly, we have tremolo. Or is it vibrato? I always get the two mixed up. One's a variation in pitch, the other one's a variation in volume. Put that right off just now. So we're back to just basics with a wee bit of reverb on it. Okay, let's go to the next one, lead sound. Now, as you can hear, the volume leapt up there. So let's just bring the volume back a bit. And if we a little bit here, bring the master down and the gain up. We have some subtle reverb, some subtle distortion, I should say, on it. But what happens when we go to the next one? Brit high. I'm a Brit, it should work for me. Well, if you wanted sustain, there it is there. Let's try a little bit of lead up at the 12th fret. Right, one more to go, and this is what they call modern. I think by that they mean 1980s. Right, back down to the crunch sound. And again, you can make that clean by simply reversing these two. So it's a very versatile little amp. It'll never get so loud that the neighbours will complain. Which is the whole point of the thing. If you're looking for something light to take to a small gig like a cafe, then the 5 wouldn't do. It just wouldn't be loud enough. There is a 10-watt version, which might be, haven't tried it, but that might be an option for you. Certainly it's very light. You can stick it in a rucksack and off you go. So far I have discovered no problems with it at all. It's going into a Tascam 8-track at the moment, and as you can hear, there's no appreciable background noise coming from it, so that's a good sound for recording. So there you go, a bonny wee amp.